Hi, my name is Jonas and I am from Danier Accounting. In this video, I'm going to make a short description of what a holding company is. We made a previous video where we briefly discussed the different company structures we have. So that was the APS, like the limited company, and also the IVS, which also is limited. And we also spoke briefly about the sole proprietorship. When we talk about a holding company, what we mainly are concerned with is when we have a limited liability company and we want to make sure that we have secured the equity and the money that we have saved up, that we secure that from suppliers, from possible lawsuits, etc. So to quickly illustrate, if we go back to the examples we had before, here we looked at an APS. The APS was the limited liability structure where we needed a 50,000 Danish kroner in equity. And we also briefly discussed the IVS, which needs a minimum of 1 Danish kroner, but up to 49,999. That's something you decide. If we say 1 kroner, then I'll write like this. So normally it works like this, that these companies here is owned by a shareholder. We can take a man here and we can take a woman here. And normally they will own, if there's only one shareholder, naturally they will own 100% of the shares. I'll make a circle here. And what happens is that after a few years, if the company is running well, then they will start saving up money every year. The bank account will grow bigger and all of a sudden they will have a lot of money on the bank account. And we can say, just as an example, that they have 5 million kroner here on the bank account and also 5 million here. So what we have here is two limited liability companies, and normally what we think is that, well, my liability is limited to the money that I put into the company, which was the 50,000 and the 1 kroner in the beginning. And that's partly correct, but we also need to remember that if it's going really well and we're saving up money on the bank account, that also is part of the equity capital in the company, meaning that the better it goes for your business, the bigger the liability you actually get. So if you have 5 million saved up in the company here, all of a sudden your liability is no longer 50,000 or 1 kroner, but actually 5 million kroner in case you should end up in a lawsuit or similar. So for some people, if they are in this situation, it's by far not the majority that ends up having 5 million on the bank account, so maybe it's not even relevant in your situation, but for the clients where it's relevant, then they start to think, how do I actually secure these 5 million? And here it's important to keep in mind that the shareholder, he has two main ways to get the money out. One is to get a payslip. If he gets a payslip, he will have to withdraw the normal personal tax. The taxation here would be much more than 50% if he took out 5 million. So that would be quite hard on the cash flow just to secure the 5 million. At least they would quickly turn into at least half, which is not very interesting for a shareholder, since he would prefer having the cash in the company so he can invest it, etc. The other way is to take a dividend. And if he takes a dividend here, then in Denmark, let's assume that he's taxable in Denmark, then he is allowed to take up to 50,600 Danish kroner here. If he takes out a dividend from 1 kroner to 50,600, he will have to pay 27% in tax. You have to keep in mind here that he already paid the company tax here, which is 22%. So if he decides to take a dividend, the tax is already 22 plus the 27, which actually gives him a tax of 49%. And this here is 2016 numbers, so it could be different naturally if you're watching this in the future. If he takes more than 50,600, the tax increases to 42%. And all of a sudden now the tax is actually up to 64%. So if he wants to secure these 5 million from suppliers and from lawsuits, well, he will not end up having 5 million on the bank account. He will have 5 million minus 64% in tax. So that's a very big decrease in cash flow just to secure the money. So I think most people will find that not very interesting. So what they can do instead is like this. I'll just erase this here. So what they do instead is that when they establish the company, I'll just put one person here because it's easier. When he wants to create this APS here, then he does just like he did before. He needs the 50,000 kroner here in equity capital. But instead of owning all the shares himself, he actually puts in another company between him and the company. So we'll do like this here. We'll draw a circle here. So this is the APS. And in between here, he actually puts another company, which we call a holding company. And I'll make a circle here. So instead of owning this company, he actually owns the holding company here. He maybe owns 100% of the shares. It could be a different percentage of ownership, but in this example, we'll say 100. And the holding company then owns 100% of the APS. In reality, the holding company could also be an APS, or it could be an IVS, but we call it a holding company because the company holds the shares from another company. And if we came into this situation like before, where we had 5 million kroner here on the bank account, then this structure here enables us to pay out a dividend to the holding company. So instead of paying out a dividend here to the shareholder, we actually pay out a dividend to the holding company. And the tax on a dividend here is actually 0%. So that makes it much more convenient for the shareholder to secure these 5 million here. So instead of having the 5 million in the APS, where they are vulnerable and they're liable for lawsuits, disputes with suppliers, with clients, instead, we can move them up here after the year is finished and we have the annual report and we know the revenue. And instead, we can put it on the bank account up here. And now these 5 million are actually secure from any lawsuits. If there is a lawsuit down here, well, all of a sudden that's isolated to the APS here, and the 5 million is safe up here in the holding company. So that's the motivation to make a holding company in most of the circumstances. That could also be other things, but this is the main reason to make it. So if you have any questions about this structure here, well, feel free to send me an email on jonas@daniaaccounting.com. You can also give me a call if that's more convenient. My phone number is +45. That's the Danish country code. And my phone number is 2627-7777. If you want to have a quote on, for instance, establishing an APS, an IVS or holding company, then on all the subpages you will see a link to get a quote where you can get a price from us for this service. So that's everything I wanted to tell you about the holding companies. Thank you for your time and we hope to hear from you soon.